friends, Sonic Toast here, running a promotion with Entertainment Earth, one of the biggest toy retailers out there. And right now, you can get 10% off any in-stock item on their site by using the URL ee.toys/toast. Now on with the video. Friends, it's me, Sonic Toast, and we're all out of Universal Monster NECA crossovers for the Turtles. So, for today's Turtly Tuesday of Terror, we're looking at this monstrosity, the Mega Mutant, from the latest movie, Mutant Mayhem. So this is Superfly at the end of the movie, sorry, spoiler alert, where he gets transformed into this giant amalgamation of different animals, mostly a whale. So this figure is actually a Walmart exclusive and goes for about $25. All right, first let's take a look at the character description. The Mega Mutant. When Superfly and his devious mutant making device fall into the Hudson River, what comes out is something the Turtles could have never predicted. He transforms into a Mega Mutant, a combination of the Hudson's many underwater critters and any other animal he encounters. And we can see a lot of details in the picture here of having an arm made out of monkeys, and up on the top his head he's got like a elephant for a nose, and he's got octopuses and giraffes on his head, and then his leg is famously made out of horses. So yep. Oh, and look, I didn't ever notice that before, he's got turtles on the front of him too. So that is pretty crazy. Now here he is straight out of the box. That's not the most flattering side of him. This is his good side, the one that they show in the box. Notice he only has one arm. The other arm, which is the Superfly claw, comes detached. You have to connect it yourself. So let's go ahead and get that on there. Okay, so now I got the arm on. It's got some articulation there. The claw twists. His mouth does open and close this much. Hey, how you guys doing? I'm Superfly! And you can close his mouth all the way. It kind of like snaps close. So, there we go, and there. You hear that? This arm moves, of course. It looks like his wrist is supposed to twist. Yep, he has twisting wrists there. And then, of course, he's got wings. He has four fly wings. Looks like each wing has a specific spot. Go. The wings just kind of click in, I guess. So there are his wings. They are disgusting. Additional articulation. His legs move and his feet twist. So that is about everything. Oh wait, and he has his tail, his big whale tail back here. That moves too. So that is all of his articulation. Overall, this thing is just hideously disgusting, just like in the movie. Here is Michelangelo for size comparisons. You can see how much bigger this figure is and how how it's not nearly as big as it was in the movie, but it is big enough to put other characters in its mouth. Ah, eat you, Michelangelo. No, don't eat me. Nom, 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 nom. You know what kind of blows me away about this character with the design is by putting all those orange octopus on his head. He looks very like reminiscent of the original Baxter Stockman fly design because of the bright orange hair. You can kind of see that, and I very much believe that was their intention, was to make it look like that. As a matter of fact, let me show you something. Shoot. So this magazine, Den of Geek, did this whole mini special all about Mutant Mayhem. What's cool about this magazine is it does show some concept art for the characters, where it does actually list Superfly as Baxter Stockman Fly. So you know at some point in the development, he was supposed to be Baxter Stockman and not a separate character, right? But yeah, I just thought that was kind of neat. Also look, it shows Scale Tail as an actual character, which yeah, he did make a tiny little cameo in the movie as like a hologram, but he wasn't actually part of the crew like it shows him here. Also, this guy, it labels as Rat King in the middle, and Rat King was not actually in the movie. Actually, this guy was in the movie, but they didn't call him Rat King. So that is kind of interesting too. Anyway, when you actually read the article though, it does talk about how Superfly is separate from Baxter Stockman. So they do have the main story just in the early concepts. It appears that Superfly was supposed to be Baxter Stockman. And that concludes our Turtley Tuesday of Terror for this week. So friends, let me know what you think of this guy, or if you picked him up for your own collection. Honestly, like, I wasn't crazy about this character, and when I saw this for $25, I'm like, I don't really need that. But then I thought to myself, someday, these are not going to be on store shelves, and I'm going to be kicking myself for having not gotten this, you know, big final boss character someday. So I'm like, yeah, I'd rather have him in my collection than not have him in my collection. So that was my thought process. All right, friends, have a fantastic Turtley Tuesday of Terror, and toast.